It's May 2016, and today I'm making a vault door. Tools and materials, PVC and a dowel rod, gold rubbing buff, a Tupperware dish, hot glue, paint, a marker, a respirator mask, goggles, a rotary tool, a conveniently shaped chunk of styrofoam from your local hardware store. This is a dumpster. Scissors, razor pens, or a box cutter. First, I'm making the parts that need to be spray painted because those will take the longest to dry. It's gonna be that large handled wheel that opens the door. I cut the rim off a Tupperware container and hot glued a section of PVC to the center of it. Then I cut some scrap foam core and used that to close up the bottom. Then I measured and cut 6 4.5-inch lengths of wooden dowel for the handles. I carefully marked and cut holes with my razor pens and hot glued the handles in place. Oh, in order to get those to fit right, I had to use my rotary tool to sand away the edges. Then I marked where I wanted it to eventually go on the door, and I spray painted it black. Make sure you do any spray painting far away from your styrofoam. While I was drying, I cut out that hole and measured and cut lengths of PVC with my PVC cutter. That would fit inside of those little alcoves, I guess you'd call them. These are meant to look like those massive deadbolts you see on bank vaults. They don't quite make sense if you think about it, but just trust me, it's gonna look great. I set all those up for painting, then I painted them. What'd you think I was gonna do? While those parts are drying, I painted the styrofoam. Normally in the film industry, they'd coat it in white glue first, or some more legit sealant, but this is more of a proof of concept piece. I used up the last of my gray paint on the second coat, but that's fine. Looks a little bit like weathering. While that dries, I'm gonna work on the parts that I painted black earlier. Now, anything that the camera's not gonna see, you don't need to waste paint on. It's just something to consider if you're trying to make set pieces on the cheap. So I coated all the black parts in gold leaf rubbing buff, which actually looks more bronze, but that makes it perfect for this particular project. You don't really need to do the backs of these parts because the camera won't see it, but you never know. Maybe the director wants a transparent duplicate of the vault door to get a shot from the vault's point of view because they're that kind of director. I don't know. Just plan for all contingencies. Oh, I also made hinge parts, which are those little gray pieces right there. I was gonna use an old gym lock for the tumbler, but it looked way too small by comparison. So instead, I made my own out of a miniature Frisbee and a mouthwash lid that I cut in half. I sprayed it black before moving on. Most of those deadbolt rods fit snugly into the alcoves, but I had to glue that last one in. Notice how the cleanest surfaces are facing outward. Then I attached the wheel. By this time, the tumbler was dry, so I went over that in rubbing buff. Finally, I glued a dial printout onto it. That's just regular printer paper. I suppose if you wanted it to look really nice, then you could print on gloss photo paper, which was an option. It's just, I don't want to waste my photo paper. And I pressed it firmly in place. Here it is with basic hinges. That's so cool. I know this is more of a bank vault, but I kind of want to put some Fallout decals on it at some point, because, you know. Hey, thanks for watching. I hope that helped out some people who are trying to make massive set pieces. If you want to see more movie prop tutorials, then you can click on these links and you can subscribe to see future tutorials. If you want to help out the channel, then you can check out my Patreon page where patrons enjoy early uploads. Also, be sure to follow me on all the social media sites. You know, I'm not even a huge user of the social media sites, but if you're on one of them like Instagram more than YouTube, then it's a good way to see what I'm making while I'm making it and when the video goes online. All right, that's the video. Jake out.